Well, a break in the weather has given salvage crews a chance to board the Stricken cargo ship off New Zealand's North Island.
And 10's Lisa Rolls is near the command centre at Tauranga. And Lisa, as they try to manage this disaster, it's already playing out in the courts.
Sandra, it sure is. And today we heard from the ship's owner. He has told the people of New Zealand he's sorry. In fact, I'll quote, he says, to the people of New Zealand, he's sorry for the oil washing up on beaches in their beautiful part of the world. Now, today we did see the second officer on that ship who was responsible for navigating it when it hit the reef at full speed in court. Now, he's likely to face $10,000 fine or up to a year's jail if he's found guilty. The captain, of course, went through court yesterday and both of those men have been released on bail. Now, the government here is already talking about possible compensation, but really this disaster has such a long way to go. There's literally an army cleaning up after each high tide, with soldiers from across New Zealand slowly, methodically scraping up kilometres of oil.
We have to do something to help, so devastation. I mean, what can we do?
The once pristine beaches around Tauranga on the North Island are so contaminated they are now off limits to the public.
This restriction of access is necessary to allow the pollution crews to go about their business.
It's not just oil that's washing up on the beaches now, but containers as well. And this is what happens when they break apart. These silver packets are full of beef patties, and these cream chunks of foam are insulation off the container. But locals say at least this mess is easier to clean up.
88 containers, including one loaded with hazardous chemicals, have fallen off the cargo ship, which is listing dangerously on a reef. A huge crack in its hull still has the potential to break the ship in two.
The vessel needs to stabilise, and it looks like it is, but it's too early.
Calmer conditions have meant salvage crews can finally get back on board to see if it's safe enough to start removing hundreds of tonnes of oil.
While this is good news, we shouldn't get too excited. We already had a complex project to start with. It's even harder now that we've sustained damage on board this vessel.
Authorities warn it could take weeks, if not months, to move the ship, and the clean-up could take just as long. At least one New Zealander has wasted no time coming up with what they think is a solution, but few here have their sense of humour back just yet. In Tauranga, New Zealand, Lisa Rolls, 10 News.